CBS presents this program in color.
You are looking at child star Dickie Moore as he appeared in the title role of the film Oliver Twist. And here is Dickie Moore in a scene with the great Spencer Tracy. And this is Dickie as he appeared in the film with beautiful Marlene Dietrich. Today, this young star is grown up. In fact, he's our first guest on To Tell the Truth. We'd like you to meet Dick Moore.
Thank you very much. Thank you, and now I'd like to introduce my wife, Eleanor.
Is this Eleanor Moore? Is this Eleanor Moore? Or is this Dick Moore's wife, Eleanor? Well, we'll soon find out as they try to fool this panel. Bert Convy, Peggy Cass, Orson Bean, Kitty Carlisle, plus 100 people in our studio audience on To Tell the Truth. This portion of To Tell the Truth is brought to you by Miracle White Super Cleaner to keep and restore synthetics to their original brightness.
It's time somebody mentioned them. Undies. You know, the new synthetic kind. Oh, they wear. But so often they come out yellow, gray, everything but white. No matter how you wash them. Blech, unmentionable. Till now. Miracle White was invented to whiten and brighten your synthetic. They're made for each other. Like shampoo for hair, nail polish for nails. Miracle White for synthetics. It's not bleach. It's not detergent. It doesn't work like bleach or detergent. Miracle White lifts out yellowing, dinginess. Actually brings back the fresh, clean look undies are supposed to have. Makes them mentionable. Of course, Miracle White is sensational for all your machine laundry, too. Oh, yes. If you're not utterly satisfied, the Miracle White people will double your money back.
And now, here's our host on To Tell the Truth, Bob Collyer.
Thank you very much. Welcome again to Tell the Truth. Good afternoon, panel.
Good afternoon. Hi.
Yeah, you're right. It is a good afternoon. The three ladies, of course, have already retired to our special soundproof room. Now it's time to question Dick Moore, who, when he was a former child star years ago, was called Dickie Moore. We start the questioning with our own movie buff, Orson Bean.
Thank you. How long have you been married, Dick?
9 years, next November 8th.
All right.
Kitty.
Do you feel there are special problems in marriage for an ex-child star?
No, I don't think any more than would be the case otherwise.
Bert.
Dick, you work with all the greatest. Does your wife ever get tired of hearing about the good old days?
I don't really talk much about them, and actually, Ellie isn't awfully familiar with the films I did. She really wasn't even very familiar with me when we first met. The first month we dated, she thought I was Freddie Bartholomew. Or something. She really did.
You really
did? Thank you.
What did your wife do before you married her?
She was a secretary.
Orson.
Do you have any children?
We have 2 children.
Kitty.
What do you do now?
I'm in the public relations business. I have a public relations firm here in New York.
Bert.
Did you say children? I'm sorry, I missed that.
Yes, boys.
Two boys. Are they named Dickie?
Kevin and Steve.
Kevin and Steve.
Peggy.
Gee, I have 2 nephews, 1 Kevin and 1 Steve. Huh. Listen, where did you meet?
We met on a blind date here in New York City. Yeah. Our friend invited us both over for dinner.
Orson.
A blind date, and it really worked, huh?
It really worked.
When you first put your beady red eyes on her, did you know then that this was the woman that you were going to spend the rest of your life with?
Well, I knew.
You were only thinking about
I wouldn't put it
night,
quite huh? that way. No, I knew I liked her very much, but we didn't really. It wasn't one of those things where lights flashed, I don't think.
Kitty.
What about her? Did she tell you later that when she put her beady red eyes on you, you were the one for her?
You know, I don't really know what she thought of me. I've never asked her. I just assumed.
You're obviously not very familiar with each other even yet.
All right.
Bert,
listen, Dick, do you think movies are better than ever?
Yes, I love movies. I like to go to them. Frankly, I don't go to as many as I'd like to because You get home and you turn on television, and there are a lot of good ones on TV, and I like to watch the old ones.
Do you see yourself on television ever?
Not much, because I don't stay up till 4 o'clock in the morning anymore that old.
That's all we have time for this preliminary questioning. Let's ask the ladies to come in from the soundproofed room. All right, panel, see if you can find out which of these ladies is married to Dick Moore. We'll start the questioning with Kitty Carlisle. Kitty?
Thank you, Bob. Number two, do you find that there are any special problems involved in being married to a person who was a child star with all the concomitant adulation and all the things that went with it?
No, I love it.
Ah. Number three, who did you think he was when you first met him?
Freddie Bartholomew.
Number one, did you think he was the absolute living end when you first put your beady red eyes on him?
I most assuredly did, because I was very impressed with who I thought he was.
Ah. And number two, do you live a sort of proper 9-to-5 life now with your children and so forth?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Number three, do you take care of the house?
Yes, I do.
Bert Convy.
Yes, number one, has Dick ever introduced you to some of the great stars he worked with?
No, not really.
Number two, would you like to meet some of them?
Us.
Why don't we try and arrange something? Number three, about your children. We have
two children.
Two what?
Two boys.
Two boys.
Steve and Kevin.
Are they interested in acting at all?
No.
Would you resent it?
No, I think that's their choice. I mean, whatever they want to do.
Thank you.
Peggy.
Thank you. Number two, I know your husband quite well, although I've never met you. He used to edit a magazine. Could you tell me the name of the magazine that he used to edit?
Equity Magazine.
Thank you. And number three, we also work on another account, your husband and I. Something to do with fabric. Do you know what that is? It's a show that they do every year.
The Milliken Show.
See, they told them everything. I thought I could sneak it and do well. Number one, how old are your boys?
Kevin is 15 and Steve is 17.
Wow.
Orson.
Number three, what's the most exciting thing that's ever happened to you two outside of that first night when your beady red eyes met across the room?
Well, our wedding was quite exciting.
Yeah?
It was a Japanese wedding.
A Japanese-style wedding. Isn't that sensational? Number two, tell me this now. What did you think of him when you first... He doesn't know what you thought of him when he says when you first looked at him across that smoke-filled room. The blind date had been arranged.
I liked him very much. I thought he was very sweet.
Well, number one, did it ever occur to you you're going to wind up spending the rest of your life with him?
It didn't take me too long to discover that.
Yeah, all right. I guess that's a good answer. Number three, now, what do you want to do? What do you want to do with the future? Did you ever want him to go back to being an old man star?
No.
There's a great feel for little old men nowadays, no?
And that's all we have time for. You know, I marvel that any of these people ever see each other in the first meeting, because according to Orson, they've all got beady eyes and, and smoke-filled room. I don't know how they get together at all. Yeah. Mark your ballots, if you will, please, panel. And while you're voting, it's time for our studio audience to vote. So again, audience, when I say vote, please select number one, number two, or number three. Are you ready? Vote! All right, those votes are marked. Let's see how our panel voted. Bert, for whom did you vote?
Well, I'm a little confused. I don't want to pry. But I think we have a slight discrepancy here. I don't know if I should explore it or not. Well, I mean, Dick said he was married 9 or 10 years, and he's got a couple of boys that are 17 and 15.
Well,
I think they were better acquainted when they met than they want to tell us.
I think we better clear it up. I have a son by a previous marriage, and Ellie has a son by a previous marriage.
Okay, that's fine. There goes my vote.
And thank you for asking.
All right, but in spite of all that, I'll vote for number two.
Peggy Cass.
I thought it was sort of bohemian. I rather liked it. I voted for number two. You know, these sort of people look as though they go together. She looks as though she goes with him.
Orson.
She looks like she goes with him, but one looks like she's married to him. And they have two kids.
Kitty Carlisle.
Well, I was so unnerved by this whole thing that I marked my vote on the wrong thing. It says game number two, and I meant to write it on the other one. Well, anyway, I voted for number two because I think they all go together, as Orson says.
Not only game number two, but my game number two.
All right, let's see who got the most votes from our studio audience. Our audience voted for number three by a wide margin. All right, Dick, would you go over and pick out your wife, Eleanor, for us, please? Dick, it's been a number of years since you functioned as a performer. Do you ever get the itch to get back into that part of the field?
This is really, I think, about all I could take at this point. I enjoy this very much, and I don't really want to go back. It was over 30 years.
And you do enjoy your public relations work, right?
Very much.
Good.
And he's good at it, too.
Thank you, Peggy. It's nice to be backstage.
Well, much happiness to you both, and continued success. Number one, what is your real name and what do you really do?
My name is Lucille Haley, and I'm an editor at Harper's Bazaar.
Thank you. And number three, what is your real name and what do you do?
My name is Sally Kohler, and I'm an associate director of community relations for the Albert Einstein College of Medicine.
Thank you. Checking the score, we find that there were two incorrect votes. That's twice $100 or $200. Thanks very much for gracing our show, and we hope you had as good a time as we did. Goodbye, and God bless you. Our next guest on To Tell the Truth is a Marine who instructs officers and enlisted personnel of the United States Marine Corps in the art of charm and good grooming. But first, this word.
We'll leave it up to you. This is an instant coffee, one of the powdery instants you've known for years. This is a newer kind of instant. Nescafe. The difference is obvious. Nescafe's granules are obviously bigger, obviously darker, because Nescafe is made with a natural process, pre-perked for you, like you perk coffee at home, to leave in the natural flavor of the coffee beans. Which instant do you think makes a richer cup of coffee? We think the answer is obvious. If seeing isn't believing, try tasting. Nobody makes instant coffee like Nescafe with natural coffee flavor. You'll find it's an obviously better instant.
And now let's meet that instructor who teaches Marines poise and good grooming.
What is your name, please?
My name is Patricia Brombarrett.
My name is Patricia Brombarrett.
My name is Patricia Brombarrett.
We'll play our game with Lance Corporal Patricia Brombarrett in just a minute. Right now, this word.
When he comes home and tracks in all that city dirt, you can clean up single-handed with Eureka's new superpower lightweight vacuum cleaner. It has a new control panel where you pick the power for the job. Deep cleaning power, more than ever before in a lightweight. There's extra cleaning width, a new retractable floor brush, and new rollers, too. Hang it anywhere that's handy. So, even when the day gets hectic, you're ready for any little emergency. Convenience and deep cleaning power. That's Eureka's new superpower lightweight, priced for the average home. Eureka, the very best in vacuum cleaners.
All right, panel, open up your envelopes, if you will, and follow along. I, Lance Corporal Patricia Brombarek, am a Lady Marine. My job is to instruct enlisted women and officers in the Marine Corps in good grooming and how to display poise and charm in all social situations. My course, which includes hair and makeup, is part of the basic training of lady Marines to teach them spit and polish female style. Signed, Lance Corporal Patricia Bromberick.
This portion of the Tell the Truth is brought to you by Miracle White Super Cleaner to keep and restore synthetics to their original brightness. The next portion of the Tell the Truth is brought to you by Tegrin Medicated Shampoo for people who find dandruff keeps coming back.
Panel, these three ladies all claim to be Lance Corporal Patricia Bromberick, and we'll start the cross-examination with Bert Convy.
Yes, thank you, Bud. Number one, you deal in makeup and hair and so forth. Are Lady Marines allowed to wear wigs?
No, ma'am. It's against regulations. Yes. No, sir. Beg your pardon.
Thank you. That's all right. As you were, Corporal. Number three, what does Lance Corporal mean? Is that carryover from the Lancer days? Or?
I don't know what it came from, but it's between PFC and Corporal.
You know where it stands, right?
Right.
Number two, is it possible for Marines to wear mini skirts? Now, your uniform is, how long is your skirt as a Marine?
They have to come to the knee.
Oh, so you can't, you don't wear mini skirts as part of your uniform. How about out of uniform?
Peggy.
Number three, is there any regulation on the length of your hair?
It can't cover your collar.
Okay. Well, number one, they won't let you wear wigs or little false pieces. Can you touch it up if you want? I mean, say you want to be a blonde.
No, ma'am.
You can't even color your hair?
No, ma'am.
Well, suppose your hair was the color of an old brown paper bag. Don't they even let you jazz it up a little?
I suffer, but no, ma'am.
How do you like that? Number two, what's that insignia cross pens? Are you a yeoman woman? Number three?
I beg your pardon?
You've got an insignia of cross. Something's there.
Oh, that's a rank insignia.
What?
This just makes Lance Corporal. This is the...
Oh, right. Okay.
Orson.
Now, number two, why is this needed? Why wouldn't the girls that go into the Marine Corps know as well as then, as well as they did in civilian life, how to be charming?
Well, we are trying to teach the women Marine to be feminine.
Yeah.
And to look very, very natural. And we feel that this course, you know, is necessary.
In other words, number one, there's a tendency when you get in uniform maybe to lose some of the gracefulness that you might have if you were in a crinoline or something, eh? And so you're trying to compensate for this?
Hopefully to achieve a little grace.
Achieve a little grace. I think that's only fair. Over
Kennedy.
The top.
Number three, do you believe you can teach people charm?
We can try hard.
Number two, we had a Marine on, a Marine captain, Captain Houlihan, I think,
yeah,
who had long hair way beyond her collar. Do you believe that number three is right, that the regulations say it can't go below your collar?
Regulations say it.
Well, she
can
had
we
long
touch
hair,
the didn't she?
Yes, but she was a captain.
She was a captain. Maybe that's it. Now, are there any makeup regulations, number one? Can you use as much as you want?
It should look natural.
But, I mean, supposing it doesn't, do you get put in the brig?
That's all we have time for. Mark your ballots, if you will, panel, and audience, when I say vote again, please select number one, number two, or number three. Are you ready? Vote! All right, let's see how our panelists handle it. Bert, for whom did you vote?
Well, I think I'm wrong, Bud, but I think that all the time. Usually I'm right that I'm wrong. Number one has great poise and charm. She really does, and so does number two, and I didn't talk to number two too much. But I don't know, number three, seems to me maybe she'd be the girl. I haven't got a good reason except she's got a medal. And maybe she got that for her job.
Peggy.
Oh, excuse me, Bert.
Peggy.
Me, okay. I voted for number three. I don't know why. Well, I think she looks as though she could teach charm. She's got an affable personality and she wears her hair very snappily and it's off her neck and I think it's three.
I think number two looks like a snappy kid to me. And if I was ever going to join the Marines, I wouldn't mind being taught charm by her. Over the top. Where's my purse? That's her. Oh, excuse me.
Well, I voted for number one because number three looks to me like a model. Now, she may be the real one because that's real hot stuff. And number...
What?
Huh? Well, being a model is sort of hot stuff, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yes.
But I think it's number one because she said, we try to teach them a little grace.
Yes.
As if this was going to be kind of a rough go.
All right, we'll find out how our audience voted and meet the real Lance Corporal Patricia Bromberick in just a minute. First, this message.
If you use a dandruff shampoo on Tuesday, but dandruff's back on Thursday, maybe what you've got isn't ordinary dandruff. Ask your doctor. Flaking and itching could be early signs of eczema, seborrhea, psoriasis. New Tegrin medicated shampoo has an invisible medicated barrier that fights bacteria for days. Plus, a medication that helps control flaking and itching with just regular use. Try Tegrin medicated shampoo. Do you clean your dentures with a toothpaste made for kids? Family toothpaste is made with things kids need, but dentures don't need. But if you take out the cavity preventer and the kids' flavor, you know what's left? Room. Room for things dentures do need, like cleaners and whiteners too powerful for a child. And an antibacterial agent to leave your dentures clean, your mouth fresh. Dentures need Dentu Cream.
All right, let's see who got the most votes from our studio audience. Our audience voted for number one. Okay, time to find out which of these three young ladies in truth is an instructor who teaches poise and grooming to the Marines. Will the real Lance Corporal Patricia Bromberick please stand up? Thank you very much. Thank you. I haven't got time right now. We'll have to find that out later, I'm sorry to say, but it would be interesting to know. Number one, what is your real name and what do you really do?
My name is Mildred Peterson. I'm a freelance writer and I live in Sexsona, New Jersey.
Thank you. And number two, what is your real name and what do you do?
My name is Sally Bishop and I'm a registered nurse and I work for the Visiting Nurse Service of New York.
Thank you. And taking the score, we find that there were one, two, three incorrect votes. Three times $100, $300 coming your way, ladies. Thanks for very much for being with us and hope you had a good time. Goodbye and God bless you. We'll be back in a minute. Right now, this word.
Well, I've never really been in this position before.
Turner Barber's trying to tell which hand is smoother. His wife's hand? She uses Lux Liquid. Or a model's. How does it feel, Turner?
I feel about the same, really.
Then guess, which one is smoother?
I believe this one is.
How about that, Mrs. Barber?
Well, I guess it's all due to Lux Liquid in Dermacell.
Switch to Lux Liquid for smoother hands.
This is a grease maker. Not much you can do about grease makers. But there is a remarkable way to break up the grease they leave behind. It's the Grease Breaker, concentrated all.
Watch, greasy oil in wash water with a leading detergent and wash water with all. All breaks up grease like no other detergent can.
There'll always be grease makers. That's why you need the Grease Breaker, concentrated all.
That's all we have time for. It's been a nice week. Have a good weekend. Good weekend to you, too, I trust. In the meantime, don't you forget to tell the truth. Bye.
This portion of To Tell the Truth was brought to you by new Denture Cream, a special toothpaste for the cleaning power denture wearers need. To Tell the Truth is a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Johnny Olson speaking, this program recorded.
It's fun, isn't it?
And who subscribes to it?
Go on. Push the button.
Think of the fun you could have on
the tube.
The tube?
You.
Tube.
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 TV tubes.
That's a lot of fun, isn't it?
It's going to be a lot more fun
if you keep going the way you're going.
Go on.
Push the button.
Please subscribe. Subscribe.
I hope they're watching.